it's your boy Roots, and I'm doing this deck profile team relinquish. And we got Mr. Robert here, South Florida's own, which is a top 32 PPT tour, Orlando's deck profile, and the Sunday 1K top four. What you got? Third place finish for
third
this one?
Third place on Sunday, 22nd on Saturday. One draw away from top 16, making my second top 16. So,
All right.
So,
All right, then. So, before anything, you want to get down to the deck profile?
Just want to say a couple things first. Shout out to Roots, PPG for holding an amazing event. Machado also, too. Still waiting for PPT Miami. It's your hometown, so we definitely waiting to go down there. We got some new stuff here if you want to take a look at that. These are my old dice from last time. They got a new season. Pro Play Tour dice. I even noticed they had a different logo, so this is real
season
nice,
one,
man.
Season two.
We got the Phil Center and how to go.
Fire Matt playing
that. Nice mat play with this. So
that's fire.
Other
right
than
there.
That, everything went good for the experience this weekend. Saturday was a good experience. I haven't played in like 4 months. I've been taking a little bit of break from playing. Just came back. This is literally my first tournament I played since like May or June. So literally, if you're talking about rust, I am rusty. But you know, came, did my thing, borrowed a lot of cards, got the stuff together. But other than that, experience was good. I had fun. One thing I like to say, you know, when you do get to play to have fun. You know, if you know you're going to take your L, or you're going to get your L, just take your L. Don't be trying to rule short people. Talk about, oh, you didn't activate Violent Chimera's affecting damage calc, and you still took the L anyway. So, if you know you're going to take the L, just take the L. And take it in shame, because it'll be real embarrassing if you really get embarrassed after the fact, because you're trying to, you know, get it in. So, anyway, in regards to what we're talking about, we're playing Sky Strikers today, so let's get into it. Three Veilers, three Ash, two Ghost Ogres put in mad work along with the one Bell. That put in work for me, so I appreciate those cards in the deck. Those are my hand traps. Didn't have impermanences because I've been playing in 4 months, and I was kind of playing for fun, so I didn't feel the need to go spend money to get those. They debug, you already know it. I would always play this card because it definitely helps, especially with the Silent Mind and the Search and they go into your combo, so that's my thing for that deck. Three Flame Buffaloes. Works out for me. Didn't it used to, but it works now. See Archiver, I was testing this. It came up, it was good. I want to test this more, but overall, it's a good card to pitch and then bring back in the next seed and go off from there. Salad cards, Jack. Play three Foxies, three Spinnies, Gazelle, obviously. We also play one Falco. I want to find an excuse to take this card out of my deck, but I can't find one yet, so to be continued on this. Next card, Mirror. A lot of people don't play Mirror. I like playing Mirror. I feel it's one of the cards I would always play. Basically, with Mirror, it helps you give you an extra extender in case your normal summon is messed up. You can, in a sense, if you draw this card or search it off a circle or a mining or anything and whatnot, you can special summon straight from the hand and then you can continue with your Baylinks and going off in your place. And if this is in your hand, you can always discard an Salamangreat card to special summon it so you can get an extra monster on board so you can go off. So I definitely like this card to save me a lot of matches. And then MVP for today, Fennec, good card. Two effects on this card. First effect, if a Cyberus monster you control that special summon from the extra deck and just draw a battle or your opponent's card effect. You can special summon this card from your hand or graveyard, so you can pitch it and bring it back from the graveyard, but it banishes when it leaves the field. But second effect is what the killer is. Second effect is if this card is sent to the graveyard for a link summon of link 2 or higher Cyberus monster, you can search game from your deck to your hand. And there's been so much times where my opponent has left a monster in the tap position that has gotten stunned by a hand trap or bricked and ended their turn. And they had the gas next turn, but they never got the next turn. Thanks to my man right here. So definitely won me a lot of games that could have been more drawn out, but definitely like that card. Other spells, Circle, Will, Sanctuary, just helped me a couple times. First time I played this card, but overall it's okay. And then other cards, Call by Graves, Silent Minens, and I also play Foolish Burial. This is extended to help you get certain cards, whether it be Jack Jaguar, Falco to set a trap, or just other cards, Foxy to pop something or get a three on the field. And then for my traps, Roar, Rage, Roar. Four of these. Don't want to search these going first. I want to draw into these so I can set them. And my opponent thinks I either got one or two, but I have more than two. Usually there's one game where I got one and I had a second one and my opponent, I forgot what he did, but I had them both set. On his turn, he tried to do something, I roared it. And then the next turn, he tried to, I think he tried to, there can only be one me, or some other card, and I used the other roar. It's like, you play two roars? And I was like, yeah. You want to put in your pin for this win, please. Okay? That's the deck, 40 cards. Let's go into the side deck, actually. Side deck, Nibiru's, you know already. Two Lantias. Blowout card. I'm going to play a third one. Two draws. Didn't get to use it, but same thing in terms of Lantias. Not as much, but I like it. I won at least three matches with this card. 2 to 3 matches on Saturday with this card. So, good card. Only one because I only had one. 2 Twin Twisters. 2 Rig Boots. I didn't get to use them, unfortunately. Imperial Order for Strikers. I won a game with this. And 1 evenly match. Doesn't really work with the OTK factor, usually evenly match in this version of my deck. So, but overall, still blowout card. So, and then extra deck. 3, 3, 2, 1, 1. Warlord. Probably gonna take this out. Gonna get some of this card. I'm probably actually gonna replace this card with Cerberus just to have something to pop in this card and possibly draw when I can link it to Wolf. And then, you know, Chimera and 2 Stallions also. So, other than that, that is it. You guys have any questions, concerns?
What was your overall tournament experience and any shout outs?
Tournament was good. I had fun, and that was the whole point. I wanted to go up and enjoy myself. I haven't played Duke in a couple months. Go up and enjoy myself. I got to enjoy myself. Got some prize winners back. Gave some people that deserve the L. I had some fun with some other players. Also, too, we had some good experiences. So, like I said, if you know you're going to take the L, just take the L. Don't try to roll short, because I will give you the L. And then you're going to feel bad, and people are going to be like, damn, you really got the L. Okay? Thank you.
All right, then, guys. This is your boy, Root, signing out. Till next time. Peace.
Shout out South Florida.